Seen this motherfucker running naked through your backyard.
We're talking video talk. We're talking
video talk, bitch. We're talking video talk. Get your video talk. You best subscribe. You best subscribe or die. You best subscribe or dive to video talk.
Hello, 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 hello. Greetings from Finland, and this is Wilho calling from you from video talk and. Nice to be live for change. Yeah, yeah, yeah. How the hell are you? How the hell have you been? I'm great. I'm fine. I'm doing this unboxing today for you guys because there's so much to unbox. So I thought it would be like an easier thing to do as a live show. And next week it's another live show because, yeah, the month is nearing its end. So, let's talk about a little bit about physical media news then in the next week, shall we? But today is an unboxing day, greatest day in the life of a video guy. So I bid you welcome everybody, and hopefully you will enjoy this broadcast. Freakazoid 85 volunteer Stephen Grimes, hello from London, cold London, UK. Yeah, it's a little bit cold here too in Tampere. Tampere, Finland, but never mind that shit, man, because it's gonna be getting hell of a lot warmer when I'm done right here. Paljomania says, hello, Wilho, hello, Paljomania, and Ace Man, always the acest guy in the world, hello from even colder Vantaa, Finland, hey. Vantaa, greetings to Vantaa too. And Movie Man says too, hello Wilho. Movie Man, welcome to the chat. Yeah. Some soda stream, water, and maybe now it's let me little bit tell you this is my back. This is my fucking back for this evening. And let me a little bit explain this package. Well, I have been buying, you know, some vintage out-of-print Winnegan Syndrome DVDs from this guy who also happens to live in Tampere. And then we were chatting in the messenger, and he was telling me that I'm thinking about getting rid of all these. He told me that, would you mind... 80s Cup has subscribed. That kind of scared me, this. announcement, the hey 80s Cup, welcome to the chat. But I was saying that, hey, he told me that he's gonna get rid of all these vintage Vinegar Syndromes because he has watched them all. I think he's a fan, big fan of erotic cinema, but he has already watched them and want to, you know, clear some shelf space for him. So he told me that, would I want to, you know, see the pictures and see if there's something that you don't have. And sure, why not? And then I said, and then I cherry picked there those things that I didn't have. He had like over 100 of these things, and I do have a big Vinegar Syndrome collection. So I took whatever I didn't have, and now I will show you what I got. And I will also, in the end, I will tell you how much did I pay for this whole lot. And also, I will tell you how much short I am for full, complete Vinegar Syndrome collection. Pulp Viking says hello. Hello to Pulp Viking, Denmark. Beta Poop Max Dennis, hello United States. Happy Sunday. Sunday fun day. Hopefully you are having funniest day of the world, of the week, let's say that. And Anni Rose, also from Tampere, Finland, has joined the chat. Hellos to you. But now, I think it's time to start the unboxing. So, are you freaking ready? Let's start this thing so we can end it also someday. So, here's the bag, and now let's put it here, and let's start rocking and rolling, baby. Okie doke. First up, Pikarama, Big Two Unit Show, Turn On with Kelly Nichols, and what is this? Silk Satin and Sex. Okie doke. So. The Silk Satin and Sex is from year 1983, and the other one, Turn On with Kelly Nichols, is from 1984. Okay. Directed by Lawrence Talbot, and the Silk Satin and Sex is directed by also by Lawrence Talbot. So, you know, it's a your usual Pikarama double unit show, and this is VS-145, this one. So, this I didn't have, and yeah, I almost get full 100 when I'm done with this box, but I cannot comment of any of these films because I don't. Well, there may be few that I have seen, but this is something that I have not seen. But I do like me some Kelly Nichols. This is not porn, this is art, says Pulp Viking. It's much better to have an avid collector of Vinegar Syndrome and not porn. To be an avid collector. No. Ace, man, you got it all wrong, man. You got it all freaking wrong. Okay, let's put that thing there and move on to the next one. Hey, naughty, too naughty to say no, and who is that? Of course, this is the one and only Ginger Lynn. I don't know how many Ginger Lynn films I have seen, but this is another one that I don't think I have. Wait a second, what wasn't this in the Blu-ray collection? Wait a second, wait just a fucking moment. Too naughty to say no. Yes, it was 5 years, 5 movies collection. Yes, I have seen this. Yes, now I remember. It was about something about this. Were they some sort of a girl's school and then. Then this other girl was fantasizing about, you know, you know what. And hey, mind you, I have to use some, you know, some language that I cannot directly say, because I know YouTube is gonna be fucking, it's gonna having a field day about this, these sort of live shows. And one more thing, I would like to talk more about these porno films, but I know that 90% certainly these things will be demonetized by YouTube, and you could even get a strike, community strike, if you are regularly doing these kind of erotic cinema things. So I don't want to do it. And okay, also I have to explain that if I'm telling you straight that most of these erotic films, most of these, I really don't have anything to say. That much to say, so yeah. But yeah, I think this was okay. And hey, it's a live show. If you have seen something, hey, you can write it in the chat. I try to keep up with you guys if you have anything to comment on any of these films. Okay, next up, Hey, I forgot to mention the number of this. This is Vinegar Syndrome 102. This too naughty to say no. And the one I already had on Blu-ray. So that was a useful purchase. Pikaramat, Pik 2 unit show, the sensually liberated female. And he and she. Never heard about these things. This is from 1970, and this is also from 1970. So basically that means that this is not hardcore, because it was not until the Deep Throw came on that hardcore was like became like a thing to show. Because before that, you could get arrested if you show hardcore films in the cinemas back in the day. But yeah. What is this all about? Inspired the best-selling book, The Sensuous Woman, Matt Simbers. Matt Simber, that's a guy who directed Blaxploitation picture I was telling you about. Was it The Iceman or something? Something like that. But never mind. Matt Simbers' farcical interpretation of the white-coated sexist genre hosted the Salter voice, Linda Quinnes, who takes a weird journey to the sexual habits of women. Okay. So it's like a documentary film. Sort of films like the Travis Bickle watches in The Taxi Driver. Pulp Viking says, I'm watching Fanny Alexander from Criterion. Okay, wasn't that an Ingmar Bergman film? Is it so? I don't think I have ever seen any of Ingmar Bergman's films. I know. Was he Swedish director. Is it a man or woman? Jörn Donner produced. Yeah, Jörn Donner, he's a Finnish guy. Beyond Shame, Sekka. Yes, I do like Sekka. Sekka is awesome. Yeah, very beautiful. A place beyond Shame. Okay. Vinegar Syndrome 153, and this previous one was Vinegar Syndrome 092. So below zero was that one, but this is 154. Okay. Sekka, Paul Thomas, Lori Blue, Mylin, Don Fernando, John Martin, and Lisa Thatcher, and directed by Fred Lincoln and Sharon Mitchell. Sharon Mitchell rings a bell, but yeah. Does she have something to do with the Mitchell brothers? You haven't seen Bergman because he didn't do a porno or horror. Neither he did action either. That's a good Sekka movie, says 80s cop. Hey, welcome to the chat. Welcome to the channel. It's a good Sekka movie in her prime. All right. I'm gonna be watching. And hey, at the end, I will be also explaining what is my strategy to watch these all. Because I'm fucked in the head like that. Because if I buy something, I have to watch it. So behind me is a shelf full of films that are not on my to-be-watched shelf. If you can spot there, there's James Cameron films, True Lies, Aliens, and Abyss. Yeah, I'm working on Aliens right now. But yeah, but I will explain it in the end how I'm gonna be approaching this behemoth of a project. Okay, and then Pikarama 2 unit shows Sweet Young Foxes and Too Young Like It Hot. Hey, guess what? I have seen them because I do have the Pikarama 4K release of these films. Exactly the same films in that. Wait a second, was it? Yes, this was the. Was this the Telephone Company film? The Young Like It. Sweet Young Foxes. Wasn't that the Telephone Company where. I really like this girl, this. Hyöpatia Lee, of course. How can I forget her name? Yeah, Hyöpatia Lee goes working on this telephone company, but. Yeah, As you might imagine, telephone services are not the only services these gals perform in the office. Yeah. And young like it hot, wasn't that this the teenage girls are having some sort of house party, and it's not just pajamas that they're not wearing any pajamas on in that party, if my memory serves me correctly. But yeah, the point is that I do have this previously, this Vinegar Syndrome 108 release, but if you're gonna be serious about collecting each and every Vinegar Syndrome release, you're gonna double dip this shit. You're gonna fucking double dip your fucking balls in that this fucking shit. It's not fucking shit. I'm just swearing to get warmed up. What kind of TV and player do you have? Hey, that would be an interesting video. I think I have done in my Finnish channel this type of videos, but I could do that also in the video talk. Yeah, I can show you my home theater systems. I don't think I have done that in the video talk. Aceman says, I should ask my friend to join this chat. He's a true connoisseur what comes to this topic. Hey, by all means. 35 people watching, so I'm thrilled if there's gonna be more people than that. Alright, hey, check this out. Pikerama, 2-unit show. Ultimate pleasure. Oh mama. I'm always ready. Okay, me too, man. I'm always ready. From year 1977, 72 minutes. That's music to my ears. And also 1978, 71 minutes. Beautiful, beautiful. Both directed by Carlos Topalina. And I have seen quite a many Carlos Topalina films. And not necessarily my favorite X-rated director, because in his films there's also kind of dumb humor in them, so. And they're cheaply done. What was this one film, Carnal Olympics, where these couple of dumbass truck drivers, they take on board hitchhikers, and you might guess where that leads. But it was a stupid film. But anyways, yeah. I think this has been released on VHS in Finland too, this I Am Always Ready. So if Vinegar would release lots of gay porno movies, you would be double dip them too. Gay porno video space. Just hey, I have a couple of gay films already. Wait a second, what was this gay guy who if there's Beta Poop Max Dennis, he probably knows this gay guy who made bunch of gay films. Moving and Take One. That is one I have seen, and I think I have to use a lot of money to get this. Was it Vinegar Syndrome number 014? It is that guy's gay film, The Bible. Gay Bible. So, maybe I have to get that from eBay. But any case. Vinegar is vinegar. But I don't remember that guy's name. I have to check it. Yeah. I have to check it now. Come on. What was that gay guy's name? Wait a second. Take One. Wakefield Pool. I have Moving, and I have let's see. Okay, the Moving is only film I have from Wakefield Pool, but also from Wakefield Pool there's Bible and Biju and Boys in the Sand. These are both from Vinegar Syndrome. Maybe I need to get these two. Oh boy. Oh man. Yeah. But vinegar is vinegar. Alright. Next up, Pikerama, big 2-unit shows. And yes, there's always two movies, so you are not gonna be short of movies. From year 1974, 86 minutes, and 1974, 76 minutes, Young Secretaries and Deep Tango. Haven't seen this, neither of these, and this is Vinegar Syndrome 039. Okay. Then, next up, Pikarama, Big 2 Unit Show, Pussycat Ranch, and Here Comes the Bride. Can a nympho limb happily ever after? There's something dirty going on at Pussycat Ranch. Okay, number 169, how appropriate. And from year 1978, both of these films, and 95 minutes the other one, and 74 minutes the other one. Both directed by John Christopher, also a familiar sounding name to me. Yeah. Let me show you also one of these DVDs. So as you can see, it is the same cover than in the cover. And these probably don't usually include any reversible sleeve. So eight films so far there. And check this out. Little show offs. Oh boy. Now I'm getting trouble with YouTube. VS 222. Okay. So this is one single film and from filmmaker Zachary Youngblood. Zachary Youngblood comes Little Show Offs, an intimate study of the sexual fantasies of real people brought to the screen, from surreal to the highly personal. Little Show Offs explores the range of erotic desire through six vignettes framed by and starring the actual people who conceived them. Sure. Okay. Yeah. Let me put that away. Naughty Networks. Okay, so this is a little bit more interesting. So I think this is one of the early porno versions of the from the Hollywood films. So this is clearly a porno version of Network, one of my favorite 1970s film, starring wasn't there the my favorite actor, actress. Come on, from Towering Inferno. Why did I forget this? From Bonnie and Clyde. Come on, somebody knows that. Finns love butter chicken. What do you mean? So how much was this? The loot second hand must be now. I will tell when I get to the end. I will tell you how much I paid for the lot. But Naughty Network, looking forward to watch this Network film. Howard Sheen has directed this film. All right. These look second hand, but must be new. Yeah, probably the guy whom I bought these probably has not watched them maybe once. Okay, Pikarama. Two unit show VS 065, Tree Ripening Cherries and Sensual Fire. Faye Dunaway, thank you, Paul Poikson. Thank you, Faye Dunaway. Yes. Network. Have you seen Pulpoikin? Have you seen Network? If you haven't, you should check it out. It's awesome. But these Tea Ripening Cherries and Sensual Fire, somehow I get the feeling that both of these are from Carlos Tobalino. Yes. God damn it. I am becoming the X-rated master. I know Carlos Tobalina film when I see it. Carlos Tobalina, both from 79 years. Okay, I think this Tree Ripening series, I think I have VHS in the from the Finnish Frequencia Gete label. Yeah. Network is amazing. Is it out on 4K? No, I don't think so. But I would certainly hope that somebody is bringing it in on 4K. I would guess that that would be something that Kino Lorber would be putting out. And Arrow in Europe. Okay, what's this? Starlight Knights and Deep Roots. Okay, Deep Roots, is this some sort of like an Indian sex film? Deeper than throat, more powerful than roots. Isn't that Roots like this kind of classic anti-racist film? they combined Roots and Deep Throat in one movie. That's excellent thinking. 79 is the make year for both of these, and both of these are directed by Lisa Barr, so it's a female director. Never heard of any of these. Kino Lorber is a pain to get in Europe. Hey, if I want something from Kino Lorber, I will always use the Wow HD, or Amazon, either one. I think I got Leviathan from Wow HD. Okay, another Pikarama. All Night Long and Tapestry of Passion. Okay. Lust, Desire, Satisfaction. A Sensuous Triumph and Erotic Romp. 1975 is the year of manufacture, and the other one is from 1976. The World's Greatest Lovers, John Holmes and Rick Lutz embark on lusty competition to see who can bet the greatest number of women over the course of one night. Alright. Sounds very interesting. And Tapestry of Passion. Hey, private detective Johnny Watt. Hey, John Holmes' character, Johnny Watt, is hot on the case of mysterious and beautiful woman known as the Black Widow, whose lovers have an unfortunate habit of dying. Alright. So it's a detective picture. Okay, VS045 was that. Did I say that already? Okay. So, I think now it's time to put some of these in the shelf. I will put them here. Hey Finland! Hey, Videomanne Gizmo is in the house. Hello Norway! Hello Norway! How are things in Norway, the land of yours? You okay? Next up, Hot Flashes. All right. This was actually I was gonna get this from the end sale from the Vinegar Syndrome sale, but I think this was sold out before I could get it. But now there is Hot Flashes. Okay, from year 1984, darring Krista Barrington, Desire Lane, Karen Sommer, Nicole Blanc, and bunch of other people. Channel 69, W6, has the hottest evening news show in the Southern California. Three foxy and uninhibited primetime anchors probe the ins and outs of local lovemaking. Yeah, I can picture it. From hands of investigation into the latest erotic techniques to explorations and international sex cultures. Intermixed with sultry advertisements for wild and sensual products, these reporters go deep into their investigation. I'm sure they will. Hot Flashes. Vinegar Syndrome 165. Wow HD is good, no tariff on top. Yeah, I recommend that if you want to get Kino Lorbers to Europe. Another Piganama. Tropic of Desire and Fantasy World. I think I watched the Tropic of Desires. Director Bokchin's lavish period melodrama. Yes, I think this wasn't too much time ago when I watched the Tropic of Desire. It was like a pretty big budgeted film about World War III in the Pacific, where these, you know, like American Marines go this whorehouse in some island, and yeah, guess what happens in that island. But it had some sort of a plot there. Yeah, it was, let's say, more classy than your usual films of this type. But this fantasy world, well, I don't know anything about it, but it is directed by Bob Chin also. And I one good thing about these vinegar syndromes regarding YouTube broadcast, that because these are pretty like made with good taste, these covers, so they don't reveal anything, so I don't have to, you know, hide it from them camera, because there is no nudity in those covers. Pigarama. Night Bird. Oh my god, it looks like a Saturday Night Fever spoof. Night of the Spanish Fly. What the hell does that even mean? I don't know. But these are directed by Felix Daniels, and the other is directed by Bob Mason. From year 77 and 76. 75 minutes and 73 minutes. Oh god, it's gonna be easy. It's gonna be damned easy to watch this. Not. And also Sharon Mitchell is starring in this. Yeah. Just chilling with Video Talk before I start a movie. How is it in Denmark? What's gonna watch, Video Man? What is tonight's film? Did any of you order any films from VA's sale that is today? I didn't order, at least I didn't do that. Because I think I have everything they have got, at least if we're talking about the main line of Winnegasson. Maybe, are there like Cinematex, are there in special sale Cinematex? Denmark is wet and cold. Okay. So now we have a picture called Sherlik Holmes. I can imagine that it's not pipe that she is licking. The master spy steps into the master bedroom, starring Harry Reams and Sue Roman. And other is Reunion. Okay, this sounds very interesting. Number VS164. Okie dokie. Director Victor Milt and Jay West. Yeah. And this guy, Harry Reams, is, I think he was in very high demand, this guy, back in the day when they're making this. I think this guy is every third film that I see. But yeah. Another to the pile. Oh god. The Love Slaves. Hells yeah. Reality becomes fantasy. Fantasy becomes reality. Oh my god. This looks that this film doesn't fuck around. Beautiful women are being kidnapped from the streets of San Francisco, brainwashed into becoming the ultimate sexual killing machines. Oh my god, killing machines. The Love Slaves. With the police hitting one dead end after another, Detective Steve Blake, John Leslie, takes it upon himself to unmask the culprits behind the diabolical operation before the violence and bloodshed continues. Oh my god, this is an action picture. Oh shit. Directed by Bob Chin. From the perverse mind of producer Bob Kress, Love Camp 7, and director Bob Chin, The Love Slaves features the talents of Desiree West, Sharon Thorpe, and Vicky Leon in this in-suspense film hybrid of hardcore drive-in madness in neo-noir release. Alright. And this is Vinegar Syndrome 154, if you was wondering. I will put that, just to be sure that YouTube algorithm will not go crazy. Ticks on 4K is cool. Shiva Baby was good. Heavy Trip is fun. Finnish film actually work on it for 1 minute. Did you now? Was it a nice set? Dixie Ray, Hollywood star. A film by Anthony Spinelli. I wonder if he's related to Joe Spinelli. No, it's not. It's Joe Spinelli, not Spinelli. Okay, VS072. Why does this sound familiar? Have I seen this? Hey. Wait a sec. Yes, now I know. It is starring Cameron Mitchell. And it was released in Finland as a, you know, a softcore version. And that is called, it's called Murder Baby. Yeah, I watched this. It's not too long ago. This was in the 5 year box. 5 year, 5 movies box. Yeah. I don't think it was very good. It was like a detective. And hey, you know what fucking pisses me off? Every fucking time, there's like a, you know, if there's a, like a sex film, why do you have to put big band music in the soundtrack? It's annoying. That's annoying. It ruins the film for me. And this was full of, you know, big band music. Every time there's an action scene, yeah. On that film, I only got weapons. They needed replicas for weapons they used in Finland, plus a bunch of other weapons. I have almost 200 weapons for movies in my storage. Do you have blank shooters? I remember back in the day when we did NATO Commando film, we had a very huge set of different blank shooters, and we used actual pump action shotgun to fire blanks. And let me tell you, if somebody's firing a blank with pump action shotgun at you, you don't want to be too close to that. You don't want to point that at a person. Okay, the big two units, so Last Inferno. No, now this looks like a badass film. John Holmes, Jamie Gillis, Marathon, an incredible contest of mighty giants. I wonder what line of giants we are talking about. Last Inferno is from year 1982, and Marathon is from also from the same year. And both, guess who is the director? None other than Carlos Tobalina. Yeah. Carlos Tobalina, the man, the legend, the myth. And this was VS091. Titillation. Now that sounds familiar. Maybe this has been even played on Filmnet, the cable channel, the Nordic cable channel. Somehow I remember there was some sort of recording like the Martti Ahtisaari, the presidential election. You know, if you record from night movies from Filmnet cable channel, the hardcore pictures, you would type there like a fake name, so boring name that nobody would ever watch it. So it was a Martti Ahtisaari's presidential election 1992 or something like that. And another tape was Olof Palme, the secret, the the solution to the mystery or something like that. Key to the mysteries. Okay, now I'm getting carried on. Titillation and Eat at the Blue Fox. Okay. 1982 and 1983, starring Ron Jeremy. I don't know, was it... God damn it. Every time I see Ron Jeremy, that guy creeped me out. You know, because of his crimes that have come much later time in the common knowledge what he did. So this guy God damn it. This guy like turns me off big time. Hyöpatia Lee, yes, yes, yes. My favorite. Hyöpatia Lee, The Rival Tales of Canterbury. Bonus feature, Hyöpatia Lee's Tasty. So two movies in one Vinegar Syndrome 0363 release. So basically, there wasn't yet a form when they put out these releases. So basically, they were trying different things. So this is doesn't belong in any Peekarama or, but basically it could be also a Peekarama. But yeah, looking real nice. Directed by Bud Lee. Wasn't that Hyöpatia Lee's husband, Bud Lee? I think he's also starring in these films. All right. Ron Jeremy stinks like hell, I've heard. Not easy to look when you're knowing that. Yeah, okay. We can add that too to his list of sins. And like they said in the Finnish porno magazine, Kalle, back in the year was 1991. Tips to pick up woman. Rule number one. Do you remember rule number one? Because I told that in one of my Finnish beer-fueled broadcasts. Because rule number one for those for those living in Norway and United States and Denmark. Rule number one, according to Kalle, is absolutely don't stink. Do not stink. Go to shower. There's no absolutely no working around that. Do not stink. Do you know if Paprika Steens Vikaren has any Blu-ray? What is that? Videomanne says, I hate shower, I need to stink. Well, then you are in direct violation of rule number one. And rule number two is, don't stink. Hot and Saucy Pizza Girls. Yes, this is definitely something that I have seen. This was included in the 5 years Blu-ray package. And this was like a hardcore comedy where there's, you know, there's a pizza parlor where the pizza delivery girls, they put some little bit extra on the delivery, if you know what I mean. And then there was this chicken wing restaurant, and was it this sushi pizza restaurant? And no, it was chicken wings restaurant, and they like there was competition and they tried to, you know, capture these pizza girls. And yeah, it's a comedy, it was all right. And John Holmes is baking the pizzas in here, so you could guess what happens when John Holmes is baking the pizzas. Desiree Kosteu, Candine Roiland, John Holmes, John C. Holmes is star. And directed by Bob Chin. Yeah. Peekarama. Vinegar Syndrome 101. Okay. Robin's Nest, The Amorous World of Bella. All right. Never even heard about the names before. One is from year 1979 and one is from year 1980. All right. Samantha Fox is starring here. Do not get excited. It's not that Samantha Fox who was the pop singer in the 80s whose song was Boys, 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 I'm looking for the good time. That would be awesome if it... That would be the same Samantha Fox in this. And it's not even, do not confuse even that to the Filipino action Samantha Fox detective, which you might remember from Too Hot to Handle. Yeah. You should watch those in the gym. Yes, that's my plan. To upload these to the iPad and then go to the... then go to the... What's the exercise bike? What was that called in English? Now I forget that. Exercise bike, I will go then and put on some vinegar syndrome. And then they are always... Okay, that's that long-haired weirdo who is always watching weird pictures. Hey, check this out. Sex in the comics. What the hell? Sex tunes and sex in the comics. So is this a cartoon? Anthony Spinelli is the director and Funky World of Adult Sex Cartoons. Now this actually looks more interesting than your usual Vinegar Syndrome sex film. Number VS113 is the number for the Sex in the Comics. Hey, come on, there's gotta be somebody in the audience who has watched Sex in the Comics. But I could be doing some specials if I find interesting, something interesting to talk about. This could be one of those. But I cannot imagine that I would find anything interesting to talk about, you know, like this, kind of like a very basic films. Ole Bornaas is one of the Orbit directors. Please tell me if they ever... what you're talking about? Viikaren. Danish distributions are not very good at doing Blu-rays. Same here in Finland. Because we live so in so small, you know... so small country, so it's not... feasible to locale these films for such a small audience. Does that have that infamous Snow White cartoon? Well, I don't know. I have absolutely no idea. Piikarama. Fast cars, fast women. Hey, yes, yes, science fiction. This is my favorite brand of 70s erotica, Starship Eros. It's a space movie. Now, what was this one weird film that I watched? It was very funny. I was telling you about that, but now the name is lost in my mind. But Starship Eros, definitely something that I might even pay attention when I watch it. Okay, time to put these in the shelf again. Afternoon Delights, Slave of Pleasure, Piikarama, VS number 178. Both directed by some guy called Sean Costello, and I think I know this name. I know this guy by his name. Afternoon Delights and Slave of Pleasure. Starring Serena Vanessa Del Rio, another fine actress. Samantha Fox and yes, Veronica Hart. And also, one of these guys, Jamie Gillis, that guy seems to be in every other two sex films that I watch. But yeah. Piikarama, big tree unit show. Holy shit, there's three pictures. My Master, My Love. And Teenage Masseuse. And then more. Harry Reams and Sue Rowan. Alright, three pictures, 64 minutes and 63 minutes. So these are a little bit shorter features. Lloyd Rain stars as vicious dominatrix who lives with her beautiful slave girl. When her brother comes to visit, he immediately becomes smitten with a slave and plots to steal her away. Alright. Right on, right on. Love Champions and Boiling Desires. Their secrets revealed. Danielle Blair, Castle Tom Byron, Roxanne Potts. Carlos Topalina. Another Carlos Topalina double feature. And this is Vinegar Syndrome 116. Alright. These two films are completely unknown to me. Ron Jeremy is starring. The guy who stinks and who is a molester. And who now is probably spending the rest of his life in prison. By the way, from Danny's films, The Hunt is awesome. It is excellent. I think that's got to be one. Okay, I have Pusher trilogy, and I have Bleeder, and then I have Riget, and then I think The Hunt is one of those that is not directed by Nicholas Winding Refn. That from the Danish films that I have. Oh yeah! Hey, this is a superhero film. Miss Magnificent. And I think that in this version, they had to blur the Superman logo out of the girl's wardrobe. Something like that. It says here, a notorious and controversial superhero spoof that fell victim to a lawsuit, resulting in its Oracle point of reference being censored. So, I think that is like a Superman logo that they had to blur. Miss Magnificent is an endearing, sleazy and funny tribute to the 30s and 40s serials funneled through the late 70s pop culture-based humor and featuring supporting performances from Sharon Kane, Holly McCall, and Mike Horner. Vinegar Syndrome brings this cult favorite to DVD fully uncut, albeit still censored, newly restored from 16mm archival elements. Okay, this is definitely something that I actually want to see. Night Caller. Do not mix this with the Malcolm McDowell film. And this is Vinegar Syndrome 211. He wanted to enjoy the most immoral acts imaginable. Terrifying, electrifying, erotic, seductive. Directed by Anthony Spinelli. Alright. My partner and I enjoy watching Carlos Topalina films a lot. Hey, Ichi, welcome to the chat. He gets right to the action. The films are essential all extracurricular activities compared to other pikaramas. Nice to meet Carlos Topalina fan. Come Under My Spell and Lady Dynamite. I think Come Under My Spell is why does it say here? It says a copy. Well, I think this looks original to me. I don't think this is a copy. Maybe it's some sort of other marking. I don't know why it says a copy. Okay. But both of these films are from Carlos Topalina, so Ichi, have you been watching this with your partner? Lady Dynamite, at least that sounds like a great picture. I think I have come under my spell as a Finnish VHS, maybe. But I don't think I have watched it. Best X-rated superhero porn, The Adventure of Dickman and Dropping. Holmes and North stay in the character the whole time. Hey, that should be something that Vinegar Syndrome should be putting out. Powder Burns, Little Sisters, and the films of Alex de Renzi. Alex de Renzi is another, you know, like a high-profile X-rated director. As a matter of fact, I watched one of his X-rated documentaries. Was it the... I don't remember what was it called, but I still have two Alex de Renzi documentaries to go on. And yeah, they were actual documentaries, you know. But yeah, he has also made, you know, dramatic films as well. Vinegar Syndrome VS 078. Oh man. Fly Girls, the Sensuous Fly Girls and Schoolgirl Reunion. I can imagine what goes on in a Schoolgirl Reunion if you're considering that this is a Pigarema. VS 248. Both directed by Sean Costello. Now, another Sean Costello double feature 10. Itchy says, I haven't seen those. I love Champions. Love Champions is our favorite. Did you watch the Carnal Olympics? Flesh and Lasers. I think I have the Frequencia Gete Finnish tape from this, but another one of these that I have not seen. And mind you that this includes Flesh and Lasers part 1 and 2. Both directed by Carlos Tobalina, none other than Carlos Tobalina. And this sounds like a thriller picture. Oh my god, there's guns and all. VS 222 is it this one. Right on. I don't even know if I have enough shelf space for this. Let's see. Never sleep alone. Well, that's a good advice. Kemal Horolulus. Horolu. Kemal Horolu is the director. Never heard about this. Kemal Horolu. Joel Leslie and Tina Marie star as Dan and Lisa Alexander, a young couple whose marriage has been put in jeopardy thanks to disagreements over what counts for infidelity. Ain't that a bitch? Yeah. From 1983. Mature, must be 18. Pikarama, Big 2 Unit Show, Fantastic Orgy. And champagne orgy. Now there's a lot of orgies for one DVD. But okay, the director Carlos Tobalin. I should keep like a Carlos Tobalin movie festival and watch all these in one weekend. Now that would be badass. Young female sex filmmaker collects the best erotic moments from Carlos Tobalina's films, featuring the hottest stars of the 70s. So it's a compilation, I see. Itchy haven't seen the Carnal Olympics yet, but I will put it in the watch list. Do you, Itchy, have these Vinegar Syndrome releases then? Okay, Carnal Heaven. Her last fling. Hey, I know for sure this is Carlos Topalinen. I think I have Carnal Heaven on a frequency of Finnish tape. Yes, Carlos Topalinen. Double feature. I think this is like, I have like 12 Carlos Topalinen films that I have unboxed here. I think I have also this their last fling as well. 1972 and 1976. Carlos Topalinen. Now, that guy, he sure made some hardcore pictures. Mylin versus Serena. Oriental Hawaii. The sensual tidal wave Mylin goes. Oriental Hawaii. Okay, Mylin. Who is this Mylin? Director. Guess who is the director? In both of these films. Mylin and Serena. Yeah, that was a trick question. And also directed by Carlos Topalinen. Carlos Topalinen was an actor in this one film called Infrasexum. Yeah. It was also from Vinegar Syndrome, but it wasn't a hardcore film. It was kind of like a sexploitation film about this guy who goes searching for himself, getting erectile problems, and goes searching for his sexual identity. And Carlos Topalinen played his friend. And hey, check this out. Prisoner of Paradise. Now there's a war action movie, and I have seen this. This was included in the 5 years collection, and it was World War II film, also set in the Pacific and also starring John Holmes. And John Holmes was a guy who was he like stranded in this like a remote island, and then there was this prison camp, and it was led by these sadistic female wardens, and then John Holmes had to rescue all the ladies from that prison, all the American ladies. So yeah, this was had more imagination than your usual hardcore picture. Bob Chin is the director, not Carlos Topalinen this time. It kind of reminded me of Ilsa. We need a Carlos Topalinen documentary or book. That would be awesome. Couple of some films still to go. Dark Dreams, a tale of erotic fantasy. How about that? Vinegar Syndrome 188, and from year 1971, and directed by Roger Guermantes. Is this even an X-rated film? I don't know. Hopefully not. Hallucinogenic sex and horror-filled cinematic trips. Trip Dark Dreams was one of the earliest attempts at a hardcore crossover, so it's a hardcore film. Hardcore crossover film and stars of the two biggest names in the early sex film, Tina Russell and Harry Reams, along with supporting performances from Darby, Lloyd Raines and Laura Cannon. Alright. Interesting. Mämmit Naamalla. Hei, Mämmit Naamalla! Hei, hei, hei! Are you the guy? Are you the guy? That's a good nightmares film. Dark Dreams. Thanks for entering the chat. Yes, Mämmit Naamalla. He's the guy. Beyond Temptation, Anticipation. Flesh Pond. Vinegar Syndrome 081 is this Pigaramas ID. And how many Carlos Topalinen? I mean, Vinegar Syndrome, they have must be put out all Carlos Topalinen films. These are two more Carlos Topalinen films. From 81 to 83. Come on. That guy was real productive. I think he's the single biggest name, if I recall, directors from these Vinegar Syndrome releases. That one name who has directed the most separate titles. Alright, Kinky Tricks, The Sinful Pleasure, and Reverend Star, and China Lost. So it's a big three unit show. Oh my god. How am I gonna ever watch all this? I don't know. But I will explain my strategy soon enough, because there's a couple of films more. And then I will explain it, the price and whatnot. So, Carles De Santos is the director for all these 60-minute features. Alright. Kinky Tricks. That sounds good to my ear. Her Wicked Ways, Ladies Night. Annette Haven, hey, that's another great actor. Louis Lewis, Lewis Levis and Harry Lewis are the directors of these films made in 1980 and 1987. And this is Vinegar Syndrome 164. Ah, all right. But Annette Haven, yeah, that's another classic actor from that era. California Gigolo. Now that's a name. California Gigolo. Oi, 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 oi. Hot Legs and California Gigolo. Now who might be the director? It's Bob Chin. Bob Chin always make these kind of more humoristic hardcore films. I don't necessarily appreciate his style making them. I like more Carlos Topalainen style. Even though he's not no master of erotica either. But yeah, Carlos, California Gigolo and Hot Legs in Vinegar Syndrome number 071 release. What do you know? Another Pikarama and big three unit show. Touch Me, Cry for Cindy. Hey, I think I have Cry for Cindy on Finnish VHS, but that is a cut version. I know that for sure. Acts of Confession is the bonus film, and these are from the early 70s, and Anthony Spinelli is the director in all of these, and yeah, these are 86 minutes, 76 minutes, and 65 minutes. So these are, oh my god, there's three discs. Holy shit. I mean two discs. Come on. Is there four what the hell? There's four pictures. Bonus feature, Acts of I don't know. Acts of Confessions, Cry for Cindy, softcore version. Ah, now I get it. It there's hardcore version of Cry for Cindy, and then there's bonus feature, Acts of Confession. Alright. Peanut Butter Freak, Creamy Style, Made from Whole Ripe Nuts, John Holmes, Turn On, Come Off. Turn On to Come Off. Hi, I'm Protein. Directed by Gerald Creston. What the hell? Okay. Starring, like I said, John Holmes and Veronica Taylor. Ever since being sexually traumatized as a young man by his aunt, Bill hasn't had an unhealthy association between peanut butter and sex. But of course, one of the strangest films to emerge from San Francisco's underground erotic film scene, Gerald Creston's Confessions of a Teenage Peanut Butter Freak, is a bizarre and surreal romantic comedy, co-written and starring Zachary Youngblood. Okay, Mammit Naamale, is this a weird film like the cover advertises? Sure as hell sounds like it. Let's try to put this in the shelf. It's a dirty film so that everybody looks greasy. Okay, The Sexorcist's Devil. The Sexorcist Devil. Deviates of Love. Okay, I gotta see The Sexorcist Devil, aka Undressed to Kill, from year 1973. A young investigative journalist attempts to go undercover to expose a local cult, but ends up facing an evil much stronger than she'd expected. And this other film, a psychiatrist discusses various case histories with a young female patient, detailing all sorts of fetishes and perversions, from simple bondage to murder. Vinegar Syndrome, 247. Very cheap, some freaks in those. Hey, man with naamalet, this is still in the plastics, didn't you watch this? Red, it's a three pictures of Red Heat, Hot Vampire, and Peeping Tom. And these are, directed by Ray Dennis Deckler. I think this film is also in the Incredible Strange film box set from Ray Dennis Deckler. And by the way, this came last summer, but I haven't still watched any of these. But this is my next big project, because I managed to watch the whole Michael J. Murphy box. There was 26 film. And now this is my next big step. And I think this includes also the Red Heat. And these are all films from Ray Dennis Deckler. Peeping Tom, Mad Life of Hot Vampire, and Red Heat. Alright, maybe I don't even have to open this, because these are in the Incredible Strange film set. I had two copies of those by mistake. Okay. Piikarama, Big Two Unit Show. New Erotic Adventures of Casanova. And the New Erotic Adventures of Casanova Part 2. Directed by yours truly, Carlos Topalina. Yeah, from year 1977 and 1982. And starring John Holmes. This is Vinegar Syndrome 074. Okay, these looks like they are set in some Victorian era. Couple of films still. My Sinful Life, The Vegas Girls. Tom Byron, Jamie Gillis, and also in the other film, same guys, probably. Okay, Vinegar Syndrome, VS 085. 085. Carlos Topalina is the director. Come on, this guy made like 100 films. I think he's probably done more, but I think I like have 100 films of his. It certainly feels so. But I think Las Vegas Girls is, I think I have the United Film softcore version of it. I haven't never seen it. Hey, more Sega. Yes, Sega. Sega is in the house. Tara, tara, tara. This is like Tora, 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 but it's a sex version. The Seduction of Cindy. Maybe this also sounds familiar to me, this Seduction of Cindy. Also starring Samantha Fox and Veronica Hart and Jamie Gillis, and also the guy who stinks, Ron Jeremy. Both are from year 1980, and both are directed by Leonard Kirtman. Not a familiar name to me. Okay, the final picture, and this is not any kind of release, because, oh my god, this is All Night Porno Show. All Night at the Bizarre Art Theater, 12 unit show, so there's 12 pictures, oh my god. And there are two two box sets like this from Vinegar Syndrome, and I think I got also from Mammoth Naamale the first picture, All Night Porno Show picture. And yes, I watched them, and yes, it certainly, it was an experience. Yeah. But these are pretty nice looking boxes, so I think the artwork is pretty awesome, and yeah, Mammoth Naamale, these are like new. Come Deadly, Daughters of Darkness, Dr. Sexual and Mr. Hyde, The Geek, Hotter Than Hell, House of Desart, Mania, Rites of Uranus, A Scorpion, The Sorceress, The Unholy Child, Waltz of the Bat. Yeah, but I think these are all under 60 minute long features, so... But yeah, it's gonna take 12 hours to watch it. But I cannot stress this enough. This feels very fine. This is like a cardboard. It feels nice. And the artwork, in my opinion, is best. It's very good. Sex-star slashers, seductive stranglers, debauched devil worshippers, all could be found in the storefront cinemas of the 1970s. In this second volume of Storefront Theater Collection, we journey to Pittsburgh to spend an eerie night at the Bizarre Art Theater for 12 of the weirdest, wildest and most unsettling skin flicks ever unspooled through the 60mm projector. Okay, I'm actually looking forward to this Dr. Sex and Mr. Hyde. And Rites of Uranus, obviously. Okay, hey, that is all. That is all from now. And I think there was 54 pictures. So, first of all, I like to thank you for, you know, keeping up this long with me. And then I would like to thank Mammoth Naamale for providing me this great set of films. Yeah, this is awesome. And now I promise to tell you how much I paid for this. And it was exactly 400 euros, so it's like, it's a lot of money, but it's like, is it like 750 per piece? So, it's not a bad price. Considering how much time would have taken me to, you know, separately trying to get these from different places, so that would have been pain in the ass. But now, this is kind of like a warp zone to my quest of getting all Vinegar Syndrome pictures. And I promise to tell you how many Vinegar Syndrome pictures I am missing. Yes, if we would count all the sub-labels, not partner labels, but the sub-labels, like Pikarama, the newer Pikarama, Cinematech and whatnot, then I would be missing 83 Vinegar Syndrome releases. 83. And I think there's like over 600. So it's okay number. But if we are talking about the main line, VS line, and by the way, this was VS 141. If we are talking about the basic Vinegar Syndrome line, from that line, I am missing 48 pictures. Glad to be at service. Hey, thank you. But now it's time to, you know, count how many, what kind of a job we are looking at. So here is my unwatched Vinegar Syndrome shelf. So yeah, it's the whole complete bottom shelf that I need to be watching. So let's calculate. Let's do some math. Okay, 12, 15, 17, 19, 21, 22, 23, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38, 39, 41, 43, 44, 44, there's three films, 55, 57, 59, 60, 62, 63, 65, 67, 68, 17, 72, 73, 74, 17, 5, 77, there's 2, 78, there's 1, 80, 82, 83, 85, 87, 89, 19, 92, 94, 96, 90, 97, 99, 100, 101, these were older. 101, 102, 103, 100 and 104, 106, 108, 110, 112, 114, 116, 118, 120, 122, and 124. So I have 124 hardcore pictures from Vinegar Syndrome to be watched. Okay, so there was a time that I was watching these let's watch 50 minutes in the evening before I go to sleep or half an hour. But then I thought, fuck that, I'm not gonna ever watch all this in that pace. But now I have done, because I'm working at home. Most of the days I'm working in my home office. So every day I will put on one Vinegar Syndrome picture. Now, I know that's not as good as watching it, because I'm watching it like a background noise. But like Mammoth Naamale says, not nearly everything here is worth watching, you know. You can easily do something else and watch it. So it's gonna take me 124 work days, office days, to watch all this. Now if I'm working 5 days a week, it's 62 weeks. Oh man, it's gonna take me a fucking over a year. Gonna take me over a year. Videmanne Kisme says, I know you're doing something else when you can watch them. Do something else. So you can figure out how much loop you need to buy. Well, why would I need a loop? Great entertainment for sure. You wanna quit? No, I'm not gonna be quitting. No, not at all. This is a challenge. This is a challenge, my friend. This is a challenge. And I will report you how my quest is going on. That's all that I have for this evening. And as a bonus feature, I can also show you another sex tape that I cut. It's a Finnish version of Sylvester Stallone, Italian Stallone picture. It is the softcore version, not the German hardcore version. But this is a very rare VHS tape. And yeah, it wasn't cheap, but I got it because I wanted this Italian Stallion in my collection. Yeah. Now I need to capture it in the computer. Whew. Okay. But I will report to you how my project is going. And now I want to thank you for watching this extraordinary unboxing show, and hopefully you have liked it, and hopefully you will hit that like button and subscribe the channel, unless you have already done so. Yeah. Thank you, everybody, and have a great rest of this week. I know in States you have so much more Sunday to go on, but here in the Finland and in the Norwegian Nordic countries, our day is nearing its end. Ace Man says, great show as always, and great tips to what to watch. Do you mean what to watch out? You watched the whole Murray box. What do you mean Murray box? Murphy box. Yes, I watched whole Michael J. Murphy box. I fucking did it. I freaking did it, man. Yeah. And now it's time to start Ray Dennis Deckler box. I will probably not do video talk about this, but I was thinking of doing a membership video to the Finnish channel about the Michael J. Murphy box. And I gotta tell you, it was not an easy project. No siree, Bob. No siree. You should make a live video of you watching these porno movies. Just face. Now that would be entertaining. Stupid Finnish guy watching porno movie. 12-hour porno show. Sammy Adams is late. I'm late to watch this one later. Hey, I'm about to stop, but hey, watch it later because, yeah, as you saw, there's a lot of DVDs that I unboxed here, the below shelf. So, that's definitely some entertainment for you. Yeah. Okay, but now, hey, I will go watch Aliens from 4K. I'm not gonna be watching Vinegar Syndrome. I watch Aliens and then I watch Abyss and yeah. Thank you for watching and catch you the next week then. Have a good week, upcoming week, and be nice. Don't think twice. Bye.